coming home, it's coming home, it's coming, football's coming home.
We'll go on getting back, so I'm getting back, so I'm getting back, so I'm getting back.
Welcome back to the video on my channel. Today is my first video of Harrogate Town's 2018-19 season. Today I was lucky enough to go down and interview Sam Weaver, the Harrogate Town manager, and I was also lucky enough to get some footage of the first team training for you guys, so look out for that in the interview. But anyway, I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to drop a like on the video, subscribe to my channel, also comment below what you want me to do for this season, like if you want to do like a prediction or a summary of the transfers, comment below what you want me to do. But anyway guys, I'll see you later, enjoy the video, bye bye. What's up guys, I'm here with Sam Weaver, the Harrogate Town manager. First of all, how's pre-season going?
It's gone really well so far, thank you. We're inside the last 2 weeks before the big kick-off and we're all looking forward to it.
When you first arrived at Harrogate Town, did you think you'd hit International League for the first time?
I hope so. I think we've all got ambitions to do well. I thought I was manager of a club in a good area, a good catchment area, and I thought there'd be a chance, but it's taken a while, but we're there now.
What was the hardest team flop you had to take last season?
Well, the hardest one, probably in the week after losing out at Bradford and Boston games.
Oh, yeah.
We just didn't want the hangover effect, you know, taking it into the playoffs. We knew where we were going to end up, which is the playoffs. And then it's trying to get the mindset right for all of us as staff and players to go and win the playoffs.
After being promoted to National League for the first time, what are your aims and ambitions for the season?
Well, we haven't set out to the fans or to the players that we must do this other than obviously stay up. So we're going to try and meet the demands of each game head on and try and get as many points as quickly as we can. And then hopefully, you know, by not setting a ceiling on our ambitions again, we can keep moving forward together, and who knows where we can end up.
If you could choose one player out of anyone in the world to join Harrogate Town, who would it be?
Well, that's a cracking question. Let me have a little think about it. Probably Ronaldo,
yeah.
Even though he's in his 30s, I think. He's still so powerful, skillful. He's got it all, hasn't he? And he scores goals. So I don't think we'd be a weaker squad with Ronaldo in it.
What is your pre-match routine?
My pre-match routine is to arrive in plenty of time and just be relaxed from my demanding duo at home and my little kids, so we can arrive with a little bit of relaxation and just we've got a routine going off now amongst the set of backroom staff. And largely they take care of it, and we just go in and name the team an hour and a quarter before the game on Saturday afternoon, 1:45. So beforehand I'm just basically filling out the set piece templates and make sure I get down to the change room for bang on 1:45.
What was your best moment last season apart from winning the playoff and getting promoted?
It's hard to look beyond the old games. I think it was a breakthrough for the club and for our reputation in the town. Certainly the first game, it was lift-off time. We just thought that we responded in front of a big crowd, and the team after 5 minutes, you know, I turned to Thurs, I said, the lads have settled already, because they did turn out in numbers, both our fans and York's fans. So to make a statement on that day, was a great moment.
Who's your favourite football player, past or present? Mine's Steven Gerrard.
Again, good question. I think, I was a massive Sheffield Wednesday fan, and I watched Sheffield Wednesday from a lot younger than you, so from when I was 4 and 5, and went through the Howard Wilkinson era, and then when Ron Atkinson took over, he brought a different brand of football, and with it, a Swedish international right back, Roland Nielsen, and he was just absolutely fantastic, and very calm on the ball, but a brilliant defender as well.
What was your best moment watching him play?
Winning the league, cup, Rumbelows Cup at the time, way back in 1991. So a long time ago, but it was a special moment because it was at Wembley, and we had three generations of my family there: my grandpa, my dad, and myself, my brother, and my mum, all of them, my sister, all of us together. And so to share that as a family was a special moment.
You've made a few signings over the summer. Who do you think will prove to be the best choice?
Oh, all of them. All of them are my favourite so far. I just think they brought each and every one a different dimension to the team and to our facets as a team. They're going to be strong players, I'm sure. Brought a bit more physicality to the squad, and it was hard saying goodbye to several members of the squad who all played the part last year, but to bring in the strength that we have done, I think hopefully it's vindicated the decisions made at the end of the season.
I'm going to Scotland for my holiday in August. It's one of my favourite places to go. Where's your favourite holiday destination?
I think Scotland's a good choice. Hopefully the weather's kind to you. I like Cornwall myself. We went down there as a family from a really young age, and for sentimental reasons and because it's a beautiful area, I take my kids down there to the beaches down there. It's like old England and a special place.
How do you feel about Harrogate Town being on TV regularly at the moment?
Proud, and I think it's good for the lads that we have outside on the pitch to just have that platform to play on now, and I think they're going to excel in it and really enjoy being on stage.
And one final question, how do you feel about Porthwell beating you yesterday in the tournament?
Well, that's your worst question so far, I've still not recovered from it, nor is my groin. But I bowed out after steering the course to the semi-finals, and my body just wouldn't cope for one more game. However, that's an excuse culture that I don't want to enter into, and congratulations to Paul and his team.
Thank you, Simon.
Thank you.